This practical is to find wavelength of HENE laser using diffraction grating. This type of instrument we will use. You can see here we have different type of scales, like this scale is there, then this scale is there, then this third scale also there. If you see here, we will try to fix the grating here. This is a grating. Grating is fixed below the instrument, in below the this microscope in this instrument, and the least scale of the circular scale, this one, will be 1 by 100 mm. This is like a screw gauge. Same way we will try to do. This instrument is a combination of two type of instrument we are using in the laboratory. One is a vernier caliper and other is a circular screw gauge. So accordingly, this circular scale will have a least count of 1 by 100 mm, or you can say 0.001 centimeter. Similarly, least count of third scale, this one, like a screw gauge. So this will be 0.01, this one, because 10 divisions are there, so divided by 10. So 0.0001 centimeter. This instrument, like we said, two type of scale. This is a scale similar to the screw gauge, and this is a scale similar to that of vernier caliper. Now, this is the picture of slit. We will try to focus on this slit. You will see the cross wire like this one. This is a cross wire which you will see with the help of microscope when this is placed below the microscope, right? This grating is put below the microscope. This type of scale we will see, and this slit will also be seen. Now, first of all, we have to measure this is a transparent portion. This is a opaque portion of the grating. So we will try to find the distance between the start of opaque, this one, up to the end of transparent. That is first combination. You can say this is called also grating element, right? So we try to find a distance for 10 such combinations from this arrow up to this arrow. We will try to put the crosswire first of all here, and we will try to measure the we will see what is reading here. Then at the second position, we will try to put the crosswire here, and then we will see the reading. Now, when this crosswire in the first position, then this will be the reading. You can see here, it is basically 2 mm is complete. You can say 0, 1, 2 mm complete. Not third, 3 mm is not complete. In between 2 and 3. So we can say 2 mm. Further, now this is second scale. That is circle scale. This type of scale is basically similar to that of vernier scale. You can see here, because 0 is here, you can say it is 79 and 80. Between 79 and 80, 79 is complete. So on the circle scale, we have a 79th division is complete, right? So on the third scale, you can see here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seventh line is exactly matching this one. So the starting reading will be, because we are discussing the previous slide, it is 0.2 centimeter, or you can say 2 mm, plus, because we are taking all the reading in the same units, that's why it is converted into centimeter, because earlier it was mm. So we will try to write everything in the same unit, otherwise it is wrong. So 0.2 centimeter, then the 79th is matching. This is least count related to that scale. Least count means minimum reading that can be taken. Similarly, 7th is matching. Similarly, this one. So if you multiply all these three, add all these three, this we will multiply, then we will add. So it is 0.2 plus 0.079 plus 0.007. So this is the answer. So this is the starting reading when the crosswire is put in the at the first arrow. Further, we will move the drum, this one, this is drum, we will move the in such a way that now the crosswire is at the third position. Here you see the reading, here the reading is 5 mm is complete, 6 is not complete, right? So further we will see here, you can see here this on the circle scale, similar to that of screw gauge, as the reading is basically a 10 here, 11, 12 or 13. 13 is complete, and further you can see here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seventh line is matching exactly, you can say here. So the reading will be 0.5 centimeter. 13 multiplied by least count, 7 multiplied by least count, add them all, that is the final reading, where means now arrow is at third position, right? So the 10th position, you can say, so 10 slit, you can say combination of 10 transparent and opaque, right? So the final reading minus initial reading will be 0.5137 here, and in the previous slide we have written 0.279 centimeter. So the diffraction grating will be, so D will be 0.234, because this is for 10 combinations. So we will, that value of D will be 0.234 divided by 10, because we have taken the 10 combinations. So it is basically 0.0234 centimeter. Further, this grating we will try to put here in front of this laser beam here, and we will see on the wall that this graph paper is placed. On this wall we will see the jet picture, we will see the light like this one, this type, this light will be seen on the graph now these will be the different type of images will be seen on the graph. You can see here, this is the center point, then this is P1, this is P2. We will try to measure the distance between P0 and P1. Further, you can see here this line, this is basically P0, this one, to Q, this is P0 to Q, and this is P0 to P1, right? This is basically theta 1 we are saying, because n is equal to 1 we are supposing. We will see in the next slide that n is equal to 1. So this distance is basically 500 we have fixed, 500 centimeters. This distance we will measure with the help of graph paper, right? Then further, these type of calculation we will do. We have to measure the sine theta, or because the general term we are talking, if it is n equal to 1, then it is theta 1 means this one. So because we know what is sine theta, that is the perpendicular divided by hypotenuse, this one, right? So it is basically p0 p1 whole square plus q p0 whole square, take the under root of that is sine theta. We know p1 p0 is equal to, from the graph we have here, this portion we have here in the previous slide, that is basically 1.5 centimeter, and this combination will be p0 whole square plus q p0 whole square, this will be 500.002 centimeter. If you divide it, so it will be 0.003, because centimeter will be cancelled, so it will be this one. Now lambda we have to find, basically, because lambda is what? Wavelength of the this HENE laser. So that is basically sine theta divided by n into a plus b. Now here n is equal to 1, and what is a plus b? We have calculated in the previous slide, that value is 0.0234 centimeter, and lambda is equal to what? Lambda is equal to 0.003, because sin theta is equal to this one, right? So we will put the value here. Sin theta we know 0.003, this sin theta, and this n is equal to 1, and this a plus b is equal to 0.0234. So if you put the values here, the value of lambda will be 702 nanometer. The exact value of helium neon laser wavelength will be 632.8 nanometer. So the percentage error will be, that is the measured value minus the actual value divided by actual value, so it will be 10.9% error will be there, right? In this calculations we have find that in this way you can take 3 readings, and then you can take the average also. Finally you can measure this percentage error also. So in this way, with the help of this microscope, right, or you can say with the help of this grating and laser, we can find the wavelength of laser, HENE laser, that is helium neon laser, with the help of diffraction heating. So in this way we can measure. Thank you.